An Indiana pastor goes drag. What could go wrong? Well, anyone can claim to be a pastor, and in this case, it's no different. Craig Duke is a man who declares himself a social justice advocate and an ally for the LGBTQIA++ community. He told Religion News Service that he appeared on the HBO docuseries, We're Here, as a way to show his support for his daughter, who recently came out as pansexual. Now, the so-called pastor went on the so-called reality show that follows drag queens as they visit small towns and recruit residents to participate in their shows. I'm David Fiorazzo, and this is Christ and Culture. So apparently Duke, a so-called reverend, served at Newburgh United Methodist Church near Evansville, Indiana, even while promoting moral relativism. Now, when a professing Christian leader compromises on principles of God's word and morality, it can be confusing to people. So let's clarify and define the role of pastor briefly and what it means to be an ambassador of Jesus Christ. We are instructed in Scripture to walk in a manner worthy of the calling of God. If this guy believes and supports things that are contrary to biblical principles, was he also teaching those principles at the Methodist Church? The Bible says those of us who are pastors and teachers will be held to a stricter standard of judgment if what we say does not line up with the truth. Now, one of the purposes of a pastor and teacher is, quote, for the equipping of the saints for the work of ministry, for the building up of the body of Christ. That's Ephesians 4, 11 and 12. In the book of Jude, Christians are warned to contend for the faith against false teachers and immorality. The Bible states, for certain people have crept in unnoticed, those who were long beforehand marked out for this condemnation, ungodly persons who turn the grace of our God into indecent behavior and deny our only Master and Lord, Jesus Christ. Now, by affirming sinful behavior or by approving of lifestyles and practices that go against what the Bible teaches, you are either rebelling against God or denying the truth of Christ. Reverend Craig Duke appears to have done just that, and he even assumed that most people in his church would be okay with his decision to promote drag queens and moral relativism on that show. He later admitted that it was clear, quote, there were folks that were more displeased with my participation than I was aware of, end quote. Okay, so how did he end up on the TV show in the first place? He was chosen by the River City Pride organization. Have we entered into some sort of alternate world here in which LGBTQ groups now support the church as a whole? Not so fast. GLAAD, G-L-A-A-D, which stands for Gay and Lesbian Alliance Against Defamation, it's a leading LGBTQ advocacy organization. It said church members bullied Duke after appearing on the drag program. So a GoFundMe page was set up for Duke, and it's already raised over $50,000. Why? Because it seems it's more popular to conform to the world's ways than to stay true to God's word. Romans 12:2 reminds us this, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect. Now, according to a statement from his church, Duke was not technically fired, as he really did not commit a criminal act, nor did he violate the United Methodist Book of Discipline. The statement says this, during his time of being relieved from pastoral duties, he will be engaging in a process of renewal, reflection, and recovery that will be monitored by our conference director of leadership development. Our desire is to provide an opportunity for Craig to again be able to utilize his numerous gifts as a pastor in a local congregation. End quote. Stop. What they want is for him to lead another United Methodist Church. Got it. So according to the RNS article, Ross Murray, and now this guy's a deacon within the LGBTQ affirming Evangelical Lutheran Church in America. And he's also senior director of training for the GLAAD Media Institute. He praised Duke's appearance on We're Here, saying that he followed Jesus' example. So wait a minute, let me get this straight. Jesus dressed in drag and promoted sinful behavior. Please show me chapter and verse on that one, because the Old Testament says clearly, you should not wear, a man shall not wear a woman's clothes, and a woman shall not wear a man's clothes. That is an abomination to the Lord. Now, Murray, this guy who works for the Lutheran Church, said this, Pastor Craig Duke gracefully engaged a community that has experienced disproportionate church-based trauma and exclusion to proclaim a message of God's love for all of creation. Pastor Craig is emulating the example of Jesus, end quote, by dressing up in drag. So Duke defended himself by saying that his message to people has always been, God loves you, period, as you are, where you are. God loves you unconditionally, and that hasn't changed, end quote. But the question we have to ask then is, does that message agree with what God's word says? In part, yes, because God loves all people, but the gospel requires repentance. To be saved, we must confess our sins, meaning we agree that our behavior is wrong and goes against God's moral law, and we have to trust Jesus and obey the commandments. There's much more to the gospel of salvation than the wonderful fact that God loves us. So in this season of Christmas, when we celebrate the birth of Christ, the incarnation, let's remember to acknowledge the Lord Jesus in ways that honor him rather than ways that please man. And let's hopefully draw others to the family of believers. God bless you. Merry Christmas, and keep speaking the truth about things that matter.